On behalf of the Southeast Michigan Chamber of Commerce, its two affiliates, the Warren Area Chamber of Commerce and the Gratiot Avenue Chamber of Commerce, welcome to our monthly luncheon. So I want to say a special thank you today to Sajos for, by the way, new member of the chamber and providing the venue here today. So thank you, Jim Sage and Sajos. Always great to be at Sajos. Great food is a testimonial to that is today if you haven't eaten yet. So in any event, so thank you, Sajos, for that. I wanted to, we have a couple of foundations that we are involved in that we're the founders of. Nobody owns a foundation, it belongs to the people at the end of the day, but the Warren Community Foundation and the North Gratiot Cruise Foundation. And so every year we do a cruise and we do a running event. So although this, to which I'm gonna speak about here, it had to do with the Warren Chamber and the Warren Cruise and the Warren 5K, but this year we raised, after that event, we raised about $10,000 for the local community. And so we gave back $2,000 to Heritage Ministries down south of Warren, $1,000 to Liberty Church for a backpack program for kids from the community. Also to Interfaith Caregivers, we gave $750 to. McRest, we gave $1,000 to. Warren Woods Tower High School was the winner of the 5K event. We gave $1,000 to their athletic program. And then we sponsored an event, Thrill at the Villa, for $2,000 for muscular dystrophy. And then finally, at our last meeting in Warren, we awarded the Warren Police and Fire Benevolent Fund $2,000. So we gave a little bit over $10,000. And so I wanted to let you know today at the Chesterfield Township Board meeting coming up in December, through the Chesterfield Cruise and the Chesterfield 5K, we raised another $10,000, and we're going to be giving out those grants at the Chesterfield meeting. We haven't picked any candidates yet. Our emphasis has always been, because we began in Chesterfield, was to support Chesterfield causes, but we haven't chosen any grant recipients yet. So if you have some suggestions of entities in Chesterfield that are touch Chesterfield, come and talk to me about it. Interestingly enough, I offered this up at the Warren Chamber. Nobody ever came to me and said, hey, what about this organization? And so I just decided on my own unilaterally my infinite wisdom as to how this might all play out. So in any event, as you all know, this chamber in particular, our calling has been homelessness here in Macomb County in particular, and especially working with McRest. And so I know April's here today, our executive director, and on the tables, a little bit of an update, but we finally got our certificate of occupancy for the Women and Children's Shelter in Mount Clemens. And again, for those of you who don't know, the flyers on the table that kind of show the building and the interior of the building and what we're doing with it. But this chamber was really instrumental in terms of leadership on the board. Many of our members of this organization sit on the board of the McRest organization. And we raised $1.6 million in total to get that thing. And when we open the doors, we have no debt, we have no mortgage. All of the funds that we raise on a go-forward basis will be to take care of our clients. And the other thing I'm really proud of, and no disrespect to our elected official friends, we did it without any government funding. We raised the money. And through grants and through donations and through fundraisers. And it took us a long time to do this, but we got it done. And some people wondered why it took so long. I wondered myself sometimes, but it happened, and all's well that ends well. The other thing is, we've really taken the leadership role on homelessness through McRest and now the Women and Children's Shelter, but there's an organization here in the county called Macomb County Warming Center, and they kind of have come unraveled this past year or two. That organization, the founder of that organization, passed away, and like a lot of organizations, what happens is the leadership goes, and then, you know, sometimes it goes ahead and proceeds, and other times it comes unraveled. And so this past year, in conjunction and with the support of the county, we at McRest, we didn't take, I don't know, I hate to say that we're taking over, but we helped operate the warming shelter. And that warming shelter, in we've had some nights this past winter where 200 people we housed probably. And the county assisted us a great deal with that, with funding and hotel rooms and the like. They still haven't found their way. So once again, this year, we at McRessive inherited that, I suppose. Somebody's got to do it. We cannot let this go unattended. And so we are working diligently to find a place to help house these individuals. And I think we've got a solution now. And April and I talked about this yesterday. But again, you know, the chamber and McRest really leading the way in that regard. And so today we have a special presentation to McRest. And so there's an organization here in this county that, and other counties that many of you may be aware of, called Impact 100. I think there's an Impact 100 Macomb and Oakland and Wayne. And so today I want to introduce Pamela Braund, who is the president of the board of directors of Impact 100. And maybe you can come up and tell us a little bit about your organization, some of the good things you've been doing, and then what's how McRest fits into all this.
Yeah. Well, I just want to say thank you for having me here today and the opportunity. I really appreciate that. Lots of great people in this audience, so pretty happy to be here. So I'm Pam Braun, I'm president of Impact 100 Macomb County. What we are is a bunch of women empowering women to really make an impact in Macomb County. And how we do that is we sell memberships for $1,000 each, and it can be split up to four people. And with your membership, you get a vote. So what that means is all the dollars that we generate from that membership go 100% into a grant that we offer out to the nonprofit community in Macomb County. And so every year we go through membership drives. Ours started November 4th, and we will take that drive all the way through the end of March, collecting those dollars. And what we do is then at the end of March, going into April, we announce the total amount of the grant that we're going to give out to the community. Year to date, we've been here 4 years, 18, 19, 20, 21, and we have put almost $350,000 into the community with high impact grants. And so every year we announce to the nonprofit community, here's the total amount of the grant. They apply through our process to submit their grant application. And then on the night of our annual membership meeting, we have the finalists come. So we have five categories: environment, health and wellness, education, arts and culture, and I'm always going to forget one. But we have five categories that we have for finalists. And those five come to our annual membership meeting and they present their grant. And it should be a special project that impacts the lives of people in Macomb County. And so they present that night, and I told you if the membership equals one vote. And that night the membership votes on who gets the award, and we announce it that night and give away the grant amount. And this year, I'm really excited to say that McRest was our winner, and they the award of $86,000.
Write grants all the time, and this is a big push. You're up against a lot of nonprofits that do great work in your community. So I usually don't get nervous about things, and I've been doing this for 19 years, and I didn't look at the recipients going into this. And day before, I'm looking, and I go to my staff. I go, how can I go up against these four other charities? We had Wigs for Kids, Michigan Hospice of McRest, and Turning Point. We all do great work in the community. And, you know, and we're all strategizing at the tables. We're like, well, if we win, why don't we just go up to the board president and say, let's split it between the four of us and call it a day. We all do great work. And then it's like, well, there's a purpose behind it, right? So there's a reason why you go up there. And the one thing I want to leave you with today is, around the holidays it gets emotional, but with McRest and the women and children we service every day, just remember in the back of your minds, the folks we service and the kids, they get two bags of belongings a day to bring into our program. They don't bring everything that your children have in their rooms when they're homeless. Two bags of belongings. I am passionate about what I do. It's just for the children we service every day. And if we can make an impact, and this Impact Macomb grant, this money here, was going right back into our building for our women and children, because guess what? There's a playroom, there's toys they can come home to every day now and play with toys and go back to school and not say, I sat at a church last night and I had to sit at a table and do nothing because they were homeless. Guess what? This building is going to make a difference in their lives. And it's been a long time coming, and I called it the money pit, but guess what? We are done, and we are ready to open our doors this winter. Thank you.
Right. I'm
not pictures.
You got pictures already?
We took tons of pictures.
Pip, thank you for what you do and your leadership and what Indec McComb is doing. And I would encourage any other women in the room here today to consider Indec McComb.
Yeah.
I didn't know of your organization. I knew that you existed, but I didn't know much about it until recently.
And really quick, gentlemen, you can sponsor a lady as
okay,
well.
Here we go.
So we will also take your money, so don't feel excluded. And I would say our annual membership meeting is open to everybody. So if you are curious about the process next year, October, November, you can come and experience it for yourself, but we do accept all takers, like corporate sponsorships and those type of things. So really here to stay, make an impact, and we also volunteer a lot for the community. We just did the dog extravaganza for the Humane Society. So we're here to be here, stay, and support the community with you. So thank you.
Thank you, Pam. A lot of great people, a lot of great organizations in our community that are making a difference. We're taking care of our own people here, and that's what's so critical in all of this. So we can't rely on government or people from someplace else to take care of our folks. We need to do it ourselves. So thank you again, Pam, for that, and Impact 100 McComb. And then I had occasion recently to work with Joey West on the new park that they're developing here in Clinton Township. Actually, it's called the, and you saw some of the information on the tables here today about the inclusive playground that they're developing with kids for disabilities. And so she had come to me and she said, hey, John, I could use your help on this here in Clinton Township. And so I've been facilitating some introductions and trying to raise money for that. By the way, I would just say this, so far this chamber, through some of its membership, has raised about $15,000 for this project. And so we'll continue to do that. We actually have experience with this. We worked a couple years ago in Warren on an inclusive playground for kids down there. And we raised quite a bit of money for their new South Warren facility, of which this playground was at. And we probably raised about $50,000 for that particular playground. And so now we're doing whatever we can to help out with the inclusive playground here in Clinton Township. So after having been exposed to the concept and what was going on here, I had occasion to work with a really great company called Total Life Changes, and they're here in our community. Actually, they're in St. Clair County. We're not going to hold that against them, but they're close enough. But they're at 26 in County Line Road area. Got a chance to meet with them and talk a little bit about some things that were going on. And they have a representative here today, one of their members of their hierarchy leadership team, Craig Cole. But he was saying to me, hey, John, I'd like to help out. I've got some equipment and so forth for playgrounds to help out with kids with disabilities. And we made an investment, and maybe you could help us figure out where we want to go with all this. And I said, I know exactly where to go with it. It's Clinton Township. And so I have Craig Cole here today from Total Life Changes, and maybe you might want to speak for a few minutes. Tell us a little bit about Total Life Changes, your commitment to the community, and what we're going to do here today.
Thank you, John. I appreciate it. Hi, everybody. What an honor to speak here. I mean, there's a lot of, you know, really amazing people here that I'm usually in awe watching speak. So to be able to speak here is amazing. Again, my name is Craig Cole. I handle all the public affairs for Total Life Changes. We are actually a company that started in the basement in Chesterfield Township in Jack Fallon's home, who was the CEO. He took a buyout at Ford Motor Company, started this company in his basement, which was a 1,600 square foot ranch on Walnut, again in Chesterfield Township. Amazing story. He had a dream that he could give people some really great things and do more for the world than what he was doing at Ford Motor Company. Crazy to think, right? Well, he did it. Started in 1999. In 2003, we became an LLC. In 2013, we moved out and into our first building. We outgrew that really fast. In 2015, we moved into the building we are now, which is about 50,000 square foot. We have outgrown it. We also, I would like to say, John, we have a warehouse in Chesterfield Township as well, Macomb County. We have grown our company to 150 countries. We have almost 200,000 people around the globe that actually sell our products. We're very proud of that. We're very proud. I gave you some samples on your tables today. We're very proud of what we do. But most importantly, we're so proud of what we do in the communities, how we embrace different communities, the things that, you know, just touch our heart and we always want to give back because we've been so blessed. With that being said, it was about a year and a half ago, I couldn't sleep, it was about 3 a.m, and I was on Facebook, and I'll try to make this quick, but I read a story, and it was a mom who was discussing adaptive playground equipment in the area. She brings her son, Benny Freeman, to different parks. He has autism and Down syndrome, and it's very difficult when you don't have an adaptive swing. A lot of the communities are struggling financially and don't have the money to pay for these. They're about $1,100 a piece. So in TLC fashion, I took it to the table and I said, we have to do something. We have to put swings in every park across every county. We have to do something and make sure that everybody has the ability to, you know, have a normal activity that we all take for granted. I don't have anybody in my family with a disability. I was able to play on the playgrounds with my kids and lift them up and put them in a swing and do all the things that we take granted. And I didn't realize that this was an issue, and I didn't know a lot about ADA equipment, but then I really did my research. And I met with Jamie Freeman, who is Benny's mother, and I got her entire story, and it was truly just heart-wrenching. And right there, we decided at TLC that we weren't just going to do what was easy, we were going to do what was right. And we initiated the first annual Benny Freeman Christmas tree lighting at Total Life Changes, and we named it right after Benny, who that story was about. We raised almost $15,000 by selling, we purchased them, and you could purchase a bulb to put on a tree. Well, we didn't have a tree big enough, so we went out and bought a 45-foot tree and had it planted out in front of our headquarters just so we could do this tree lighting. With that money, we were able to purchase 10 adaptive swings. Today, I would like to donate 3 of these swings, which you can see are for those that are handicapped to make it easy for their parents to get them in and out. And that's what she was struggling with. So Mr. Cannon, I would like to donate 3 of those to you today. It's our pleasure. But that's not all. So I've had the pleasure and the opportunity to meet Joey West. Joey is truly a pleasure, and she introduced me to Paul Gillingham. So I met with them last week on Veterans Day, and we went out and walked around and took some tours of some different parks. They took me by Neil Reed Park in Clinton Township, and wow, if you haven't seen it, you need to see it. It has an ADA compliant baseball field. So the base paths are able to roll a wheelchair. I've never seen anything like it. I think it's truly amazing. With that being said, our second annual Christmas, Benny Freeman tree lighting, is December 8th. It's a Wednesday, 5 p.m. to 8 p.m. I wish and hope that all of you come. There will be carriage rides, Santa, a live DJ, reindeer, fire pits, whatever, it's all free. Donut trucks. And the money that we raise this year is going to be donated to you, Mr. Cannon, for Neil Reed Field. It's something that is very near and dear to our hearts. We do want to change the world, and if we can start with each and every community, we're going to do so. Once I saw that park, I knew it was a no-brainer that we had to do more and help that park out and just make the initiative yours. So thank you for, Joey, taking me around, giving me that opportunity. I appreciate this opportunity to donate those things to you, and I look forward to an amazing December 8th, and hopefully we'll see a lot of you there.
What a great company. You know, one of the things that I wanted to emphasize in particular about their company is, Craig stated, it started in a guy's basement in Chesterfield. And last year, this company, right here in our own backyard, did $800 million in sales worldwide. It's amazing. It's an amazing story. But thank you for your commitment. And
TLC is working in a number of communities and making a difference. And by the way, you have a bunch of TLC products on your table here today. I encourage you to try them. I've been utilizing them myself. The one I like best of all, though, is NutriBoost. I think that's what it's called, NutriBoost, yeah. NutriBurst, it's a great product. So if you're into health and wellness and vitamins and that kind of stuff, you know, it's worth taking a shot at. And then their coffee is exceptional, too, if you're into coffee. So, but anyways, thanks for all that. So again, you know, really making a difference. But next today, I want to get a little update on what's going on in one of our major communities here in Southeast Michigan and in Macomb County. And so we have the guest speaker today is Bob Cannon, our supervisor. But I wanted to say about Bob. So Bob and I have known each other for 35 years, long time. Long time. Mostly on the same page politically, mostly, but always on the same page in terms of making a difference in our community, whether it's Clinton Township or Southeast Michigan, or making a difference in the lives of people. Bob and his wife were, when I first embarked, and the chamber first embarked on the McRest building, you know, Bob and Cheryl were some of the first people to step up and say, we want to be part of that. Of course, Bob would always ask me, John, what the hell's taking so long? You know, but we got there. And but thanks to Bob. And I know Bob's a really incredibly committed person to this community and really has made a difference in Clinton Township. And I'm proud to call Bob my friend. Welcome, right. Bob.
Thank you, John. Craig, you made me cry a little bit. We have a lot of swings and slides, and we try to make them all adaptive for children. We have some similar to this in our several of our parks, including Reed and George George. And a nice story is, one day about a year or two ago, I got a call from a lady who said they didn't want regular kids using the handicapped swings. And that was a mother of a regular kid. The handicapped mothers said, let them use it. Our kids want to see them using that and having fun with the things they're having fun with. So now we're going to put more of them in our parks, thanks to you. And we'll continue to do that. We're very committed to that. And April, I apologize. My wife is a type A personality. She's not laid back like me. She probably has called you more times about that building than anybody else.
That's okay.
I do have one bit of sad news. Bob Steiner, long-serving trustee and treasurer in the township, passed away the other day. His funeral is Monday. He's laid out on Sunday. Bob served with dignity and pride here in Clinton Township for 22 years. Now, you're probably a little afraid of what I'm doing because I'm a retired teacher, 25 years, and I'm used to speaking long time. I'm going to be short. We came up with a strategic plan just before COVID hit, and that was a big thing for us, but we continued the plan and implementation of the plan throughout the COVID crisis. We went back to work in Clinton Township the first day the governor allowed us to. We were open for business. We didn't miss a beat. So the first thing we had on our list for this strategic plan was ensuring quality roadways. Now, John asked me to bring a few things that we're doing in the township to let you know what we're doing. All of you know about M59 because you probably tried to drive it from Romeo Plank to the freeway. That's going to stop construction for now. It'll start back up in the spring. If you've been down Garfield, you know they're doing a great job. But it takes a long time to do a stretch like that. They've kept their businesses open. We're very pleased about that. If you drive down 15 Mile, it's closed several lanes now. You can go one lane each way, and it's closed on 15 Mile here in Clinton Township in the border of Fraser, because if we didn't close it and Candace Miller do her job, we would have another sewer collapse. So you understand why we're doing that and why there's going to be inconvenience for probably about a year. The Cass Avenue Bridge, has anybody been over that? The bridge was reconstructed. At the same time, we received a grant from SEMCOG to put a walking, biking bridge over that river, and we put it in, except the plan wasn't accepted by the county. So we had to go back and redo the plan, which is why the bridge opened and then it closed again. Everybody said, what's everybody doing? Well, we closed again because they didn't like the plan. We had to redo the plan and come back and get it approved. And after it was approved, they had to order the parts for this bridge. It'll be very nice because that fits in with another part of our strategic plan. The Harper Bridge was rehabbed this year. It'll be done soon. And we had a real nice project on Lipke Road. Probably most of you have not been on Lipke Road. There's no houses. There's several apartments. There's nobody to help pay for a road. As a township form of government, we're not like Warren, we don't get money from the state, and we're not like any other city. We have to figure out how to help finance our road projects with our current funds. Well, we were doing a water line project down Lipke Road. So with our water line project, we had to tear out the road. The county said they would pay for half, and our water department paid for the other half. So they're going to get a beautiful road soon. That starts next week. So that's the roads. The next, we talked about marketing and communicating our assets. We have a new website. We have a new logo. Jim Perpich is here. He's the one who developed that. So if there's anything you need about that, let us know. We are hiring an economic development coordinator to help us with the third of our plans. Now, let me just tell you about a few of the things that are happening here in Clinton Township. I think that anybody who drives through Clinton Township or has seen Clinton Township or who works with the DDA like Pete Thomas will be very pleased about this. How many of you are familiar with a piece of garbage property, kitty corner from the jail on Grosbeck? There's Buck's Garage, there's a that will now be, it's called East Town Village. We just approved it. It's a PUD or Planned Unit Development. 29 single family homes, 106 townhouse condos, a 6,000 square foot commercial building, and a 4-story senior living facility all on that property. Nobody ever thought that property would be developed. We're very pleased about that. Other Grosbeck properties. The Mi Pueblo restaurant is now open. They bought the restaurant, redid it. It took them almost 2 years to redo the whole building. A fabulous Mexican restaurant. He also bought the property that was next door. There used to be an old gas station, if you remember that, years ago, next to the Dunkin' Donuts. And he's going to utilize that property. And next to them is going to be a power center, a retail building with a Starbucks. So 7,000 square feet with three buildings right next to that area. And a Chipotle in front of the Myers. That's all on Grosbeck Highway. We're very happy. We're very happy about that. Also on Grosbeck, I don't see Nick Labdis is listed up. Oh yes, Nick Labdis has a self-storage facility going in. That will be the last self-storage going into Clinton Township where you'll be able to see it. All the rest will be in industrial areas. We have our share. That will be probably the nicest looking facility in the state of Michigan for self-storage. But it doesn't bring a lot of jobs. So we're looking to see how we can get jobs and more people into the community. The Story Point Maple Ridge development is on the former Mork property on 19 Mile Road. There will be 177 units with assisted living and memory care and 72 unit duplex ranch condominiums developed by Pulte, right across the street from the hospital. It'll be a very nice development. The property has been vacant for a long time. McLaren Hospital Outpatient Surgery Center on Harrington Street. If you've driven down there, you've seen the pillars going up. The nice thing about that, I've always said McLaren was in Clinton Township. I kind of lied. They're really on the border of Clinton Township. And half of the parking garage is Clinton Township. All the new construction is now in Clinton Township. In this case, these are taxpayers because it's a private development who's going to lease the property to the hospital. So our assessor's going to be happy about that. Henry Ford Hospital has a 5-story, 160-bed addition going on 19 Mile Road. And on Gratiot and 15 Mile, there was an outlot there for years. Remember the old wards out there? They had to clean that property up, which they did. And then the owners of the property thought it was worth gold and nobody would buy it or put anything in it. Now we have a power center, retail center, again with a Starbucks on the end unit with the drive through. So we have two new Starbucks going in the township, one on Grosbeck and one on Gratiot. I have one other thing to talk about. The property at 16 Mile on Grosbeck, where the Kroger used to be. Carlos Santee and I, years ago, worked with Kroger, and we worked with the owner of the property back then, and they wanted to put a gas station in. And Carlo figured out how to do it, and we gave them permission to do it. Then the owner of the property didn't do it, and Kroger moved out. So that's what the start of the demise was on that property. However, and it was bought by a fellow named Jim George, who we all love in Clinton Township because he's given us George Park, and he's doing a lot of other positive things. He bought it, and he was going to do something else with it. It didn't work out. He just sold it. The owner of the property is going to redo the entire center, and he's going to put a restaurant in called Joe Cool's. Has anybody ever heard of Joe Cool's? That will be the anchor of that property. And this is the first time I've talked about it. I've saved it for today. So those are some of the top developments. We have many more going on. We've emphasized Grosbeck and we've emphasized Gratiot, but when they do something at 19 Mile, go ahead and do it. Let's put them in. Or Garfield, it doesn't matter. We are developing a river trail system. Clinton Township has more rivers than anybody around. We have all three branches of the Clinton River. We have more creeks than you can imagine. And it's hard to drive sometimes around Clinton Township because we don't have enough bridges. We had to put an extra fire hall in to take care of the community because of the driving problems. So we are working on getting more areas for people to put a canoe or a kayak in the water, handicapped. And that's exactly what we're working on. We tore down with a grant a house over by the George Park. So next year, you will see a lot more parking, especially if you go during prom or homecoming season, because everybody wants to go there to get a picture with their dresses on. And not just them, but grandma and grandpa, mom and dad, aunts and uncles. It was a horrible problem. That will be corrected. That's in the process of being corrected. So we're very happy about that. We have a non-motorized network. We're putting in many more pathways throughout our community. And again, we're very happy about that because we're trying to get people out walking, biking, etc. During the pandemic, around our civic center, we had all kinds of activity. We like that. So we're expanding our biking and walking trail from our civic center all the way over to the George Park. So when you see that bridge going over the Cass Avenue Bridge area, we're going to have bike paths all leading up there. In fact, what they're doing now is they're putting in the bike path along Cass Avenue. That'll be done this year. Early next year, all the rest of it will be connected. You'll be able to get from Macomb Township all the way down to 16 Mile on the bike trail down there. And we're, again, very happy about that. During the year, we in Clinton Township honor our veterans at every opportunity. We have a partnership with VVA 154 and Resurrection Cemetery, which is unbelievable. We have Memorial Day, 9/11, we have a POW MIA Vigil, Veterans Day, Wreaths Across America, which is coming up in December. We take every opportunity, the three groups, our Township Board, Resurrection Cemetery, and VVA 154, to honor each and every time. We had this past year the Wall That Heals for the third time in 11 years. That is the three-quarter size replica of the Vietnam Wall in Washington. There's only two other communities in the country that have had it three times total. I intend to bring it back in a couple years so we can be number one. We had privately raised money for a Gold Star Monument. And what that is a monument to people who have lost a child, a son, a brother, in a war. And that is on our Civic Center site. It is absolutely beautiful. It was raised all private funds, just as we are doing with the handicapped swing area. We had, again, our Festival of the Senses came back this year. We had our Gratiot Cruise, big success. Not as many parties along Gratiot, but a lot of cars and a lot of happiness. So we like that. We've already talked about the Inclusive Playground. That'll be on the Civic Center site right next to the splash pad that we put in this year at no expense to the taxpayers. Reed Park, I'm glad you brought that up. We call it the Field of Dreams. It allows children to play baseball the way all of us want to play baseball. If you haven't seen it, the field, you should go see when they play. And not only that, we have a lot of other little things over there. We have real nice restrooms, places to have picnics. We have pickleball. The money that's being raised now by this lady who I used to coach against at Little League Baseball years and years ago is going to be for a bigger baseball field, which a township board has already authorized the property to be used for. And the reason why? Those little kids got big and they still want to play baseball. So we're going to have two Field of Dreams, one for adults and one for kids. And we do have some adaptive swings over there. We have to figure out, I'm going to let DPW figure this out where they go, because it is a big deal and we really appreciate it. Those are the highlights. I mean, I could go. Remember, I'm a former teacher. And I've been on this township board for 37 years, so I've got a lot to talk about. But thank you, John, for the opportunity. We're proud, and I meet with our fellow supervisors throughout the year often because we share what we're doing and try to help each other out. That's the only way to go. Thanks, John.
Thank you, Bob. Thanks for coming out, everybody. I hope you enjoyed it. Have a great day.